In this video, we'll compare Rust and Golang side by side in Kubernetes. I created a few dashboards to measure CPU, memory, and latency of the applications. For example, on the top graph, you'll see CPU usage in percentage relative to the limit given to the container. We'll create Docker images for Golang and Rust and deploy them to Kubernetes. To expose our applications to the internet, we'll use Nginx Ingress Controller. The benefit of using Nginx Ingress Controller over the native AWS application load balancer controller is that it exposes Prometheus metrics for each ingress. In that way, we don't need to implement any application-specific metrics on the application level. For example, latency, traffic, and errors we can collect from the Nginx controller. To gather CPU and memory, we'll deploy CI Advisor to Kubernetes. And of course, Prometheus using Prometheus operator. I'll walk you through the setup and explain how you can reproduce this benchmark test. You can find the source code in my GitHub repository. To create Kubernetes, I use Terraform. You can also find the Helm chart to automatically deploy Nginx Ingress Controller. I customized a few variables here. Here are the custom resource definitions for Prometheus operator and a bunch of monitoring components, including CI Advisor, Grafana, Ingress, Nginx, and kubestate metrics to get container limits, and the operator itself. To create Rust REST API, I used one of the most popular frameworks, Rocket. In the app, we have a struct to represent a device. Then for the load test, we'll use the Fibonacci sequence function. We have two endpoints. The first one is GET, and it returns all the devices connected to this app. The second one is POST, and it's supposed to create a device. To simulate some load, we'll run the Fibonacci function. In the end, we initialize our app and add two routes. To create a Docker image, we need a Docker file. In the first stage, we build the binary, and in the second stage, we use a smaller image and copy the binary there. Here we have Kubernetes deployment files. It's pretty much a vanilla deployment, also using environment variable to expose the Rust app on all network interfaces. Also important to note that we have a resource block. We'll use the limits from here to calculate the usage, then the service object to load balance pods, and ingress to expose our application to the internet. Now, if you want to cross-compile the image, for example, I'm on the Mac M1. For me to build the image for AMD 64, I had to include this setting. It's just a workaround due to the high memory usage. It forces to use git CLI when Rust builds the index of the crates and then clones them. Now, the Golang, we have exactly the same logic here. I also use the most popular JIN framework for building REST APIs in Golang. Struct for the device. The first endpoint returns all the devices, and the second one creates a device and uses Fibonacci as well. Then we have a multi-stage Docker file and similar deployment files with environment variable to run it in production mode. You can also find some dashboards for CPU and memory, and the second one for latency. If you want to play with apps locally, you can use this Docker Compose file. In case you want to reproduce, initialize the Terraform and apply. For each new tutorial, I always update all the providers, libraries, and dependencies. If you want to get always up-to-date code, subscribe to my channel. After you apply the Terraform, you'll get a fully functional and production-ready EKS cluster with the Nginx Ingress deployed using Helm. To connect to the cluster, you would need to update your local Kubernetes context. Then a quick check that you can connect to the Kubernetes. Create custom resources for Prometheus operator and deploy all the monitoring components. Make sure that all the pods are ready. Finally, we can deploy the Rust app to the Kubernetes. Then the Golang app. We'll use the same staging namespace for both of them. Both pods are up and running. We also have two ingresses created for Rust and Go. To use ingress, you need to create a CNAME record pointing to the Nginx Ingress load balancer. It should take a few minutes for DNS to sync up. Now, let's test the Golang REST API first. The device's endpoint should return two devices in JSON format. Next is the GET request for the Rust app. It also works, and we get the same response with slightly different headers. Let's also test the POST requests. Golang returns the FIP with the desired number. Next is Rust. It also works. In about 15 minutes, you'll notice that even in idle mode, Golang has spikes in CPU usage, probably related to the garbage collector. The memory usage is also slightly higher than Rust, and we haven't even started testing yet. In all the charts, the blue line represents the Golang, and the red line is for Rust application. For the first load test, let's use the Hey tool to produce some load. It will perform 10 million requests using the GET method. We'll spin up 50 clients and restrict to 100 100 requests per second per worker. Let's run both Golang and Rust API at the same time. In a few seconds, you'll notice that CPU usage of the Golang is higher than Rust application. The same applies to memory usage. CPU usage difference is almost 50% difference between Go and Rust, in Rust's favor, of course. This means that you need fewer resources to run Rust applications, which means you can save money and save the environment by migrating to Rust programming language. At this point, we basically only testing the REST API frameworks, Rust versus Gen. In the second dashboard, you can find latency graphs. In the first one, we measure P99 percentile, which represents 99% of requests completed under that duration. The second graph uses P90 percentile. You can also notice not only the difference in CPU and memory usage, but actually Rust has lower latency as well. It's not a big difference here since we don't have any load in the apps. Now let's move to the high CPU intensive tests. For the load test, we use post requests for both applications. In this case, we have a single worker and rate limit to a single request per second. Now we see a huge difference in CPU usage. Golang uses almost 82% relative to the limit and Rust around 19%, and no significant difference in memory usage. For the latency, it is also a huge difference. For the Go app, it's almost a whole second, and for the Rust, it's only about 365 milliseconds. By playing with Rust more and more, I find it attractive for my future projects. It's not as easy to get started as with Golang, but it's definitely worth it. I also have another video where I test AWS Lambda written in Go versus Rust. You may find the results very interesting. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.